Hi, today we continue the teardown of the EM25 German military radio with first this base plate with power supply unit. So another overall look, it is called the ground plate. A big aluminium mounting plate with shock absorbers. The main connector to the radio and here to the control box. This information. So I found information about this particular connector here. It is for daisy training several radios to use them together in as a relay or something like this. And we have this sturdy cover. But first, a quick look inside these shock absorbers. Because, why not? It will allow to have a look at how they are made. We have maybe 8 millimeters screw thread in here. Four regular slotted screws to secure it in place. And it will just lift off like this. They are not exactly symmetrical, you can see. We have this rubber part branded apparently Effle. Something like this, seems very German, model number here, and it is all, and here you can see how thick this mounting part is, really, really serious stuff. Okay, let's pop off the cover and see what we have. So the SEM25 version will have one-third, approximately, larger base plate with a larger module in here. Maybe we will find out what this thing is also. So here we have 6 captive screws. So you can see already this cover is really something strong. It is more or less armored. So in the receiver and sender transmitter version, the power supply unit in here will be the same, I believe. But we have a larger relay unit, this one. So here is the cover for you. Manufacturer logo, and again it's on part number. Okay, so we have 2 modules, and you can see here, look at this. I was wondering what this thing here is, but look, we have some provisions for extra wiring with this screw-on terminals just in front of this, so I believe it is just a cable exit you can use to connect a cable. So maybe if I try to unscrew this, quite hard, I can hear some kind of a rubber seal. Maybe this will come off. Wow, pretty serious stuff here. Ah yes, look at this. We have actually a seal, and this here seems to be a plug. In fact, you will remove, and you instead you will put a cable. But for water tightness, they did plug it with a piece of metal. And it is just a cable gland or cable exit with a seal. Okay, so one solved mystery, which is always good. This is really something, guys. Wow, not super easy to install. I will do it later. Okay, so about these modules. So as all the other modules in the radio, you have the wiring that is built in the case, and very well secured, and you have modules you can remove. Here, two of them. This little one is the relay module. So in the receiver version, it is much bigger, this relay module. And you can see in here, not much to see in fact. We just have one golden connector with here three relays. At the other side, behind this cover, nothing to see, just wires interconnecting everything. It is called the relay ENSATZ, with three mid-grade relays, of course. This one is branded Schaltbau. Okay, you can see the connector, the screw terminals, screw things, and really nice wiring everywhere. But now I can undo the power supply unit, which is quite a sturdy and big unit. Excuse me, I do not see the screws. Secured by three super large screws. Really quite something. Okay. So this will disconnect like this with one connector, and I believe here is the schematic for it. So we have what seems to be probably some kind of a switch mode power supply with at least one transformer here, or yes, it is rectified here. We have here the two big transistors we can see at this level, apparently two Q2 and Q3. Okay. So what do we have in here? Let's open it. So like most of the other modules in the radio, you will see the cover here is secured by just two screws. And the wall internals will slide out. Such. What do we have here? A pretty serious die-cast mounting frame, you can see. And again, super old school parts. Most of the volume is occupied here by this shielded transformer. We have apparently one second transformer here. Not sure where it is on the schematics, by the way. I am not even sure this is the correct schematic. But we have one circuit board with old school, probably germanium transistors. Look at this. Or diodes, in fact. Yes, we have just two legs. Wet tantalum capacitors which are epoxide to the board. One transistor here, by the way. So here, a big transformer toroidal or something like this. Here, apparently, trim pot. And on this side, this particular Aero Foley West German capacitor. And it is almost all for this module except the two nice Motorola transistors here with golden legs, as you can see, a big bolt to secure them in place and a golden base plate. About the screws to the frame, you can see we have this kind of a tunnel in metal to guide your screwdriver so you will not touch any electrical contacts when you slide your screwdriver in. It is good. Okay, and again, super super nice golden connector here with wires soldered like this. Even the nuts are golden here, so really a nice little unit. The cover is just steel. And about what we have in the base module, you can see how thick and sturdy it is. A guide pin here to the power supply unit, and the wiring secured to it very well. As you can see, double metal clamp here to the shielding of the coax. Thick wires here on the power supply input, obviously. And a lot of wires going here to this main connector. Okay, so really, really something serious. We continue by having another look at this cable. I will try to open this side because this one should be complicated because the cable is coming in the cover, but here it is coming on the side, so you can see the very serious construction here, cable retainers, but it looks like this cover might be possible to undo. And reveal the internal construction. So here, countersunk 3 mm slotted screws, painted in olive green, of course. They are not terribly tight. So, what do we have in here? Okay. Ah, you can see a pretty serious seal on the cover. The retaining screw to the connector secured by one circlip here. And wires buried in here coming out from the cable. And it seems like it is epoxide in the bottom, so no much luck here to take it further apart. Apparently the connector piece is secured by screws here, but as it is completely epoxide, it will not come off anyways. And you can see they barely had the space to fit the wires in here. Quite impressive. So I assume the other side will be the same construction. with extra difficulty of a cable coming through the cover. Quite amazing. Just look at the thickness. We must have 5 millimeters here thickness of this wall. So this is really quite something. Yeah, quite definitely impressive. Yes, it is coming like this in the radio. Okay, now I will assemble this and we will have a look to the control box to conclude this video. The control box. We have, as I did so previously, frequency adjustment, function switch, main power switch, preset channel selector, volume control. And it is all. I have the schematic of it. Apparently, it looks like we mostly have switches, a lot of switches, and resistors. A lot of resistors. The pinout here, it is, sorry, it is written super small, but. And very convenient, the pinout of the audio plug. Mass, microphone, not used. Speaker. And the transmitting control switch. I believe it is all what we have. Plus 6 volts. Okay. So, here we have the interesting preset frequency selector. There is here a little window allowing to read which one of the presets you are at. So it is following the position of the switch here, obviously. But you will notice the number here of settings you can access are the opposite as almost from the position switch. On 4 I am at 10, on 5 I am at nowhere, and you can see actually they did not populate here the little adjustment parts. So to set them, you have this tool in the cover that is just pin with a hole, in fact, and you need to slide these things. So this one is out of the way, it seems, and this one is out of the way. No, we are at 47 here, quite weird in fact. It is not easy to tell what you have to do with these things. This one is obviously in stock. We have here this one set on either 50 or 00. Because if you want to, can move this, but you cannot move it out of the way on the other side. And here this one will not come in the way. It is really weird. So if I remove this one, quite interesting setup here. Complicated and not very user friendly because I do not know if I am at 37 or 60 here. Interesting. Really, really weird. So we will find out inside what it is driving. these pins. Of course, cover with seal and spring action. So, to open this unit, it is just a matter of undoing the four screws. When look here at the nice army stamp from the Navy, it seems, or Navy aviation maybe. The audio connectors here I did replace as I did specify in the first part of the video. So to open this cover, the first thing you have to do actually is to remove this securing screw because it is captive in the base part of the box. Like this. And then you can just undo the four screws and the cover will simply lift out. Like, supposedly, like such, but actually, yes, it was retained by the big connector here, so in the box, just the wires, interconnecting everything, the audio plugs here are insulated by a plastic part, you can see. We have some kind of mechanical protection here, guide pins to the connector, really, really serious here. And this is pressure relief screw, I believe, something like this. Again, very thick walls. So here is what we have inside. Very, very impressive. So there is this cover, normally. You can just remove the screws on the side and it will hinge like such. But for my own convenience, I will undo it completely because it will be in the way. Seriously. The slot on the screws here is super thin. On my screwdriver will not fit. It is a common thing with vintage equipment. Super thin slots on screws and modern screwdrivers are just too thick. Quite weird. See the change screw designs. So for this, usually you need jeweler's screwdrivers. Watch repair screwdrivers, something like this. Okay. So this is just a reinforcement frame in steel. So what do we have in here? Quite interesting. So you can see a lot of wires going everywhere. The main golden connector to the case. Here a multi-layer switch, function switch, where the contacts are actually tracks on circuit board pieces. One extra board here with a bunch of precision resistors. Same construction here, apparently, for the two main frequency selectors. So it is interesting because we both have mechanical and electrical action on these switches because when you turn them, it will actuate also the display, the frequency display. So it is all synchronized together. Over switch here, the same construction exactly. Relay, by Allied Controls, and the big volume control is actually a super tiny potentiometer. You can see here. Looks very much Allen Bradley construction. And above the preset channel selector, we have this. Apparently, a wall army of contacts down here. Silver plated, it seems. Wired to this bank of resistors of a weird shape. It is actually on the schematic, probably this part here at the bottom. So can I try to unscrew this unit? I will not take apart very far this box because you can see how intricate it is, but it looks like this unit. Actually, I can remove the screws and I should be able to flip it out of the way and have a look at least at the overside of it, or maybe a better look at the internals. Not sure how many wires we have, but most of the wires seem actually to be here. I believe it is something I did never do with my previous SEM25. So, okay. The mechanism is here is locked by the switch, so it will not turn, and here also it is good. We have here a better look at the drum with all the settings. And yes, as you can see, we have only a few wires interconnecting this unit. Here are the indications of active channel and the channel you are setting. And here, it is nice because now we have a good look at the mechanics in this. Look at this. When you move this button, you can see it will move a little flag in front of the display to deactivate the display. Very nice mechanical counter in here. Very old school bulb here. And it is all micro switches everywhere also. Okay. Super, super nice mechanics in here. Quite impressive stuff. Wow. Very well made. Just think at the number of hours needed to assemble all this. Because back in the time it was made in the 60s, so all handmade, no robots back then. I believe, at least, nice Alu logo here to specify it is made in aluminium. Okay, and these weird settings here. Super, super nice stuff. So, if you have the opportunity to grab even scrap condition SEM25, you can see the amount of good parts you can retrieve. A lot of probably still good precision resistors, a lot of regular hardware. The wire seems to be Teflon sleeve, so high temperature wires you can solder easily. Super nice connectors. And a lot of good metal to recycle. So if I find if I have an opportunity to find scrap units of these radios at a little price, I will probably get them and have fun taking them apart completely. But this one for now is part of my collection, unless I find a much better one or much worse one, and this one will remain in my collection. I do not know yet, but I am now seeking for one to take apart completely just for the parts. Okay, so very, very nice view here of the control box. Wow. Very, very nice. Okay, I will put this all back together and stay tuned for the next part of the video where we will have a teardown, at least this video of a teardown where we will open the main radio unit. So, thanks for watching. Bye bye.